wanna get you all alone now and go hide away from the lights, but I don't dare to, I'm too fragile, and for that I do.
Hey friends, and thank you so much for watching today's video. In today's video, I'm gonna show you how I created this green sparkly eye look. But the first thing I'm gonna do before I go in with any eyeshadow is prime my eyelids. I'll be using the MAC Cosmetics Soft Ochre Paint Pot with a P84 brush from Sigma Beauty, which is my favorite brush to apply this eyeshadow primer. This eyeshadow primer will make sure that my eyeshadow will stay in place all day, and that's of course what we want. The next up, I'm gonna take this palette from James Charles and Morphe brushes, and I'm gonna take the white color with a MAC 242 brush, and I'm gonna apply this underneath the highest point of the eyebrow. This is gonna highlight the brow bone, which I think looks really pretty. Also, when I blend shades in my crease, I feel like it blends a bit easier because it kind of blends into the white eyeshadow, and I just feel like the transition starts looking a lot nicer straight away. So this is just like a really easy trick to make the transition look better. Then I'm taking this palette from Huda Beauty, and I'm gonna use this lime green color with a Sigma E40 brush. I'm starting to blend this all the way from the inner corner to the outer corner. I really wanted this shade to be really there, so I went a few times back in with my brush and added a little bit more of that green color to make it look as green as possible. The next, I'm taking the James Charles and Morphe palette again, and I'm gonna take this green shade. This is slightly darker than the green shade in the Huda Beauty palette, so I kind of wanted to slowly start by building up the color and make it a little bit darker, so that's why I went in with this color. I do have to say, in this video I'm using quite a few different palettes, and I know that might be a little bit confusing, but for this look I just wanted to be creative, and there wasn't really a palette that I had with like have like all green shades that I was looking for, so I had to grab a few different ones to kind of have the colors that I wanted to have. If you're recreating this look, you can of course grab all of your palettes as well and see like what kind of different greens you have and combine them together. Then I'm taking this palette from Vice Art, and I'm gonna take the darkest green shade, which is again slightly darker than the one that came in the James Charles and Morphe palette. Now I do have to say, like, for the first step I went in with the Huda Beauty one, that shade kind of looks similar to the one in the Vice Art palette. So if you want to recreate this look, if you are like obsessed with the shades that I use today and you're really liking like the first green color and this one, you are good to go with only the Vice Art palette. Then I'm taking this shade, which is by Makeup Geek. I will put all the names of the products that I use today in the description bar in case you're curious. And I'm going to use this all over the eyelid using a MAC 242 brush. Then now I'm taking this loose pigment from OPV Beauty, which is such a beautiful loose pigment. As you can see, it has like a really vibrant shade. I'm not really sure if it's like yellow or green, it's kind of in between. But I thought this would be so pretty to pop in the inner corner, so I'm doing that with a really tiny pencil brush from Morphe Brushes. And I'm just pressing this on the skin in the inner corner. I went in a few times with the shade to like make it as bright as possible. So now for the eyelid, I'm gonna use this gel from Makeup Studio in combination with this glitter, which is so freaking bomb. I will put the name in the description bar. And I'm gonna use this combination of the gel with the glitter together to press this all over the eyelid to make it like really sparkly. Then now for my eyeliner, I'm gonna take this new liquid liner from Anastasia Beverly Hills. I've used this in all my previous videos. It's a really nice liquid liner, and it's really matte and really black, which I really like. I'm gonna use this to create a simple line above the lash line. I'm not going for a wink liner today. I wanted to keep it a little bit more simple, have the focus like really to be on the glitters. So I'm just doing like a simple line above the lash line. So now next for my face, I'm gonna take this Too Faced primer from Too Faced, which I already said. This is like a really nice hydrating primer. I feel like Lately, I'm really into more hydrating primers instead of matte primers. Then for my foundation, I'm gonna take this Fit Me foundation from Maybelline, one of my favorite drugstore foundations. And to apply this, I'm taking a Real Techniques buffer brush. Now, this video was supposed to be a talk-through, so that's the reason why some moments you can see my mouth moving. But my microphone, I'm having so much issues. I actually bought a new one and I can't wait to film with it. But I was filming all day and I uploaded the footage on my computer and there was no audio. So frustrating because I put so much effort into this video. So yeah, I'm kind of bummed that it happened, but it is what it is. So that's the reason why I'm doing a voiceover right now. But hopefully now that I have a new microphone, my next upcoming videos are all going to be talk-through videos. I feel like this way I can be a little bit more personal, like a little bit more, maybe explain a little bit more details. So yeah, really excited for that. But right now I'm highlighting my face. I'm using the Tarte Cosmetics Shape Tape Concealer, which is one of my favorite concealers. I actually saw that Benefit dropped a new concealer, which I'm really excited to use. I'm not really sure if it's kind of the same as the Tarte one, but I'm really excited to try it out. I'm definitely gonna do it in one of my upcoming videos. So now I'm taking this contour, and I'm not even sure what the name is. It's a contour, like bronzing gel kind of something from Huda Beauty. Of course, again, I will put the name in the description bar. I'm using it in the shade medium and it's amazing to contour the jawline. Then I'm taking this liquid highlighter from Becca Cosmetics in the shade C-Pop. So stunning, so beautiful. Like, this is one of my new favorite liquid highlighters. In this video, you can see how stunning it is. I applied it with a beauty blender. And if you apply this on top of your like liquid foundation that you have applied, it will just give you a really natural glow. Then I'm gonna set the under eyes with a F35 brush from Sigma Beauty with a little bit of loose powder on it. And then the rest of the face I'm gonna do with my beauty blender and my setting powder, which is the Laura Mercier Translucent. But I didn't want it to go with too much powder on top of the liquid highlighter, so that's why I went in with a brush instead of a beauty blender. Hope that makes sense. So now I'm taking the green color, which I used for the crease, and I'm gonna blend it all the way underneath the lower lash line. Now, if you recreate this look, you can also do like a smoky lower lash line if you're feeling like doing a little bit more of a bolder version, but I wanted to keep it a little bit more soft. And then I went in with the Huda Beauty palette and also taking this super light green, mixing those two together and now blending it all the way underneath the lower lash line. I went a few times back in into the shades to make it really like blown out underneath the lower lash line. And the brush that I'm using right now is the Morphe M506. Then I'm taking the pigments again from OPV Beauty. I'm gonna apply a little bit more in the inner corner and also blending it a little bit downwards towards the lower lash line, so lower lash line kind of connects with the inner corner towards the crease area. I just feel like whenever I'm doing this, I'm always going back with a little bit more at the end. Then now I'm taking the Benefit Cosmetics Roller Lash Mascara, my all-time favorite mascara. I'm using it in almost every video and I'm gonna use this to coat my lashes. I'm doing this on the upper lashes and the lower lashes. And then now I took these beautiful lashes from Dark Swan of Denmark. I believe these are called Adore. Super beautiful. They have like really nice lashes. And I'm going to use them to apply them with some tweezers. And the lash glue that I always use is from House of Lashes. That one is like amazing. And now that I have applied my lashes, this is the end result with the lashes on. So now we're gonna finish off the rest of the face. I'm going in with the MAC Cosmetics lip pencil in the shade Cork. This is a really nice nude brown kind of shade. If you use it really light-handed, it's like a really nice light brown nude. But if you press a little bit harder, it's actually quite dark, as you can see right now. So if you have a nice brown, like a light brown kind of nude, you can definitely use it in combination. So I'm gonna use that. I'm gonna take this liquid lipstick from Dose of Colors, which is a brown nude. And it's so pretty because the lip pencil is like slightly darker, so you get like a sort of shadow line around, which gives a little bit more depth. I think it looks really pretty. And then now for my highlighter, I'm gonna take this C-Pop highlighter from Becca Cosmetics. I also use the liquid highlighter, as you can see, absolutely stunning. So when you apply this on top of it, it's gonna be extra intense and I think it's absolutely beautiful. You can see how popping it is. Then I'm taking the Maxi Blush from Rimmel London in the shade Sweet Cheeks, a really gorgeous peachy blush, and I'm blending this on the apples of the cheeks. Now on top of that, I'm gonna take the Warm Soul blush from MAC Cosmetics. This has a slight glow, so I felt like applying this on top of the Rimmel London blush gives it a little bit more of a sheen, which I think looks really pretty in combination. Then now I completely forgot to use any bronzer, which I normally do before applying blush or highlighter, but I just forgot it. I have no idea why, but I felt like something was missing, and then I realized, oh, I haven't used any bronzer. So this will give a little bit more warmth, and I feel like it looks so much better with a little bit of bronzer. And then here you have the finished result. I really hope you all enjoy watching this video. Like I said earlier, hopefully my next upcoming videos are all gonna be talk through videos, so I'm really excited for that. But yeah, I really hope you all enjoyed. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you did enjoy. Also, don't forget to subscribe and hit on the notification bell if you want to get a notification every time I upload a new video, because YouTube is playing up. If you aren't like putting the bell notification on, you won't always see that I upload a new video. So definitely do that if you enjoy my videos. And yeah, thank you so much for watching, and hopefully I will see you all in my next video. Bye guys.